Hi all. These days, we have all been staying at home more and venturing out less. Well, this is perfectly understandable because now the top priority is safety and well-being of our family. Well, this also means that we are ordering from restaurants less and puts a lot of pressure on many of us who are cooking continuously healthy meals. So, thinking of variety and bringing variety is always a challenge. But let me tell you, with the best ingredients, the right ingredients and great appliance, we can bring about variety in our cooking and satisfy the taste cravings of our family. Today I'm going to share a nutritious and super tasty Andhra style pesaretti, and I'm also going to share a perfect chutney that is a great accompaniment to this breakfast, great breakfast, or it can even be served as a dinner. So without delay, let's start cooking. To make tasty pesaretti, you will need 1 cup of green gram and 1/4 cup of rice. Now I'm going to wash this twice. This is very important. So I washed it and now I'm going to add water and soak it for around 3 to 4 hours. Now along with this, I'm also going to add ginger. This is around 1 inch ginger. Then I'm adding 8 to 10 cloves. Add this for great taste. Next, I'm going to add green chilies. This you can adjust according to your spice preference. So it has been soaking for around 4 hours and now comes the most important step, grinding the batter. Here is where using the right appliance makes a lot of difference. I use Bajaj, India's number one mixing appliance brand, and mixer grinder with NutriPro feature. It retains the nutrients of the ingredients while grinding. Draining the excess water and adding the rice and dal mixture into the jar of the mixer. See, and water I'm going to add as and when I'm grinding using the small opening in the top of the jar. So we need a smooth texture for this pesaretti. So you can see I'm adding water. Once the batter is ground, making pesaretti is very easy. I'll show you the texture. See how beautiful it looks. Perfect texture. I'm also going to add little water to the jar and add that water also to the batter. Add salt and allow it to rest for 30 minutes. And by that time, let's make the chutney. So I've got all the ingredients for chutney. So first I'm going to add ginger, chopped ginger into the jar of the Bajaj mixer grinder. Next, I'm adding jaggery. Next, dry red chilies. This adjust according to the type of chilies you're using. Next, I have soaked tamarind in water and extracted the thick pulp and adding it to the jar. Next, I'm adding asafoetida. Next, I'm adding turmeric powder. You can find the exact measurements for all these ingredients in the description box below. Next, I'm adding salt. This is a very delicious chutney, a must try. Okay, curry leaves I'm going to use while tempering. Now, I'm going to grind all the ingredients. So, I'm using the smaller jar to grind the alam pachdi. The model that I am using is called Twister DLX that comes with twist locking lids on all the three jars and an innovatively designed lid for hands-free operation. So our chutney is ground. See, beautiful it looks. amazing texture. I'm transferring it to a serving bowl. And next, we are going to temper this allam pachdi or the ginger chutney. Now, I'm heating a pan with oil. I'm using sesame oil here. Next, I'm adding fenugreek seeds. We all know how good it is for our health. Next, I'm adding mustard seeds. And next, urad dal. So the mustard seeds have started to splutter. I'm adding curry leaves and switching off the gas. Now I'm pouring this tempering into the chutney. Smells yummy. Ginger is so good for health. Looks beautiful. And the best part is you can even store this pachdi in a clean dry bottle. Now we're going to make the pesaretta. So to a grease tawa, I'm adding the pesaretta batter and spread it just the way you'll spread your dosa. You can make it small or big depending upon your preference. I'm drizzling oil on the sides. And I'm going to add finely chopped onion, green chili, ginger, and if you want, you can even add chopped coriander leaves. Gently press it with a ladle. Here is a pro tip. If you want, you can cover it with a lid just for a few seconds. See, so beautiful it looks. Crispy, doesn't stick at all. Look at the texture, amazing. The trick here is to grind the batter right. A crispy, delicious, nutritious pesaretta is now ready. I'm serving it with the ginger chutney, allam pachdi. Raghu, pesaretta and allam pachdi. Taste
wow.
And tell how it is.
Wow, it takes me back to my Andhra days. Ma, pesaretta is so good, and that allam chutney, that sweet and spices hitting you, oh, it's incredible. I think I've been transported to Vijayawada.
Thanks, Raghu. So you're going to soak your rice and dal now, right? I'm sure you're going to get loads of compliments when your family tastes this delicious pesaretta and the super spicy and tangy allam pachdi. I'm waiting to hear all your feedback. I'll see you soon with another delicious recipe. Till then, happy cooking!